Docker in Docker technology in Kasm Workspaces is possible with the help of Sysbox. This technology enables creating embedded pentesting labs where a vulnerable environment is running as an inner Docker container inside a Kasm workspace. This is very beneficial for training purposes. A user can do the hacking in the same workspace that has the vulnerable environment set up. The vulnerable environment would be readily available to exploit when the workspace is spawned up. In this video, I'll show you how to create a pentesting lab with the OWASP Juice Shop image preloaded inside a Kali Linux desktop workspace. To do this, you need to have Sysbox installed. Follow our written guide or our tutorial video to install Sysbox on your host machine and make it work with Kasm Workspaces. Once you have Sysbox installed, create a new image from the Kali Linux base image with Docker installed. Here is a Docker file you can use to build the image. Now that the image is built, load it into Kasm. Go to Admin, Workspaces, Add Workspace. Set the workspace type to Container. Give your workspace a name and a description. Make sure it is enabled. In the Docker image field, give the name of the Docker image that you just built. Make sure to also include the tag. Set the number of cores, memory, and GPUs you want to allocate to your workspace. Also, do not forget to set Sysbox RunC as the runtime for this workspace. You can copy-paste this config to your Docker run config override to do so. Finally, save the workspace and launch it. Once the workspace is launched, you can open the terminal in your workspace and cross-check if Docker is properly installed. Now that we know Docker is installed, you can go ahead and manually pull the inner images to your workspace. Don't worry, as this only needs to be done once. In this example, I will preload the workspace with the OWASP Juice Shop Docker image. You can pull multiple inner images in the same way. Now that the image is loaded into the workspace, we can write a startup script to automatically start the inner image when the workspace starts up. To do this, create a file at /docker-startup/custom_startup.sh. For this example, I'll use this script to wait until the desktop is ready and then start the Docker daemon if it's not already started. And then use the Docker run command to start the Juice Shop image. Also, do not forget to make the file executable. Now that everything is set up, we will create a new image from the current session. To do this, go to your admin panel and then sessions. Select the current session and click on Create Image. This will display a pop-up where you can choose a name and tag for your new image. You can also set your registry URL here. If you don't have a registry or don't intend to use one, you can fill this field with the default Docker registry URL. Finally, click Save, and this will start a background job to commit the container and create a new image from it. Depending on the image size, this might take several minutes to complete. Meanwhile, you can configure different settings for your new workspace, like give it a friendly name, description, etc. When the image is done creating, you will be able to list it by running the Docker images command. And that's it. You can now go ahead and launch your new workspace. And as you can see, the inner Juice Shop image is automatically started and we will be able to access it from the same workspace. That will be all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you want to look at the written guide, check the description below. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.